Hello there. We are all here. Welcome to What the Flip. Christy and Alonzo and Matt and Ben. And there was a show called Roseanne, and then there wasn't. And then there was again, and then there wasn't. And it has been a really tumultuous and like head spinning rise and fall with this most recent incarnation of Roseanne.
Yeah,
yeah.
I did this show yesterday, the Damage Report, the morning show here at the Young Turks with John Idarola, and it was shortly, I guess, within a couple hours after the Roseanne story broke, and we were discussing what ABC was going to do, and I thought that John, in a moment, put too much pressure on them. I'm like, hey, you know, look, they get 24 hours to sort of figure out, and it turned out they needed like 2.5. and then within 30 minutes of us finishing taping that show, it was gone. And now, you know, I tweeted something too about Roseanne. I tweeted with the meme of Bill Murray from Stripe saying, you can't go, all the plants will die, when she said she was leaving Twitter. And I put it out there, and then like 45 seconds later, the show had been canceled, and I was like, you know what, I'm piling on. I'm out. I don't want it. I deleted it.
Did
and
you
now,
really?
Yeah, now I'm disappointed in myself.
Yeah. This whole thing is bananas. I mean, for the one thing, I think that ABC maybe had this whole plan of action ready to go.
In case something happened.
Just in case, it was the button that they had to like lift the lid off of and go pink. Because from the moment that they hired her to come back in the first place, like they knew that she had been retweeting birtherism stuff. They knew that she had said the same joke about, monkeys about Susan Rice in 2013. They knew.
Right, the oven picture.
Yeah.
Right?
That was for Veep magazine, which was meant to be satirical.
I'll give her that.
It just didn't come off right. Yeah.
But it's the kind of thing that people can throw it or now out of context, but we'll let that one go. But there's still tons of other stuff. There's, she was retweeting Pizzagate bullshit. And she was retweeting birtherism stuff. Right. So they knew what they were getting when they rehired Roseanne. But, and ABC wanted a piece of that sweet, sweet, like Trump America action. And they got it. They got it, right in the face.
We should say what happened, by the way. We didn't say. So she has had a nutty Twitter presence, but then the show became like the number one hit at ABC,
Number one broadcast show of the year on broadcast television.
Okay.
But the numbers were declining.
Even with the decline.
No one's watching network television anymore.
And certainly that was, probably initially a bit of the novelty of, what's she going to do? What's she going to say?
And they renewed her for a second season after the first episode.
Aired. Right. There were great expectations. And we talked about the show. We're like, there's no way this thing can sustain itself like this. And we were right. But the way it shook out, I don't know that we necessarily would have expected that she tweeted something. And it wasn't even like a random tweet out to the world. It was like a response to somebody else. And comparing Valerie Jarrett to Planet of the Apes
and a Muslim brotherhood.
And it was a horrible joke. She said later on it was a joke, but even as a comment in any way, it's horrible. And she said it was a joke at first. And then really quickly, ABC canceled her show. Like, they did the right thing and fast.
Actual consequences occurred.
And it was fast. And then she said, okay, I'm going to get off of Twitter now. And then she came back to Twitter like within hours, not even retweeting people who were saying supportive things to her and trying to further elucidate us as to what she was thinking. She was on Ambien.
Yeah.
Now, Ben, you've been on Ambien.
I have, yeah.
Will you tell us about the various racist things you have thought and not tweeted on Ambien?
So anti-Semitic on Ambien.
Everybody should see the emails that you send us.
Oh, yeah, that's right. That would require me responding to an email. That's not true.
I would like to see the email.
Give me some more Ambien. That's right. Ambien does, what is true is that Ambien is not the most reliable drug in the world for if you act on it, I think, inside 8 hours. I mean, it's different for everybody. For me, Ambien symptoms are if I wake up before 8 hours or run, everything's fine. I'm myself. I just might not recall what happened, but I've never done anything peculiar. I get up, I go to work, and then sometimes 2 hours later, I'll be like, I don't remember picking out this shirt.
But it looks really good on me.
But I nailed it.
Keeping it on.
Right. But that's one of the reasons why I try very hard not to take Ambien, because there is some. It does have some, and the day I stop taking Ambien, whether I've taken it 4 straight nights or 1, I have dreams that that Dolly would be fascinated with.
Well, do they involve answering emails and correspondence?
My friend Winter Mitchell tweeted, I bought a PS4 on Ambience once. It showed up at my doorstep, and I was like, wow, what a nice person. That nice person was me on Amazon Prime at Ambient at 2 or 3 in the morning. I slept shopped, still not a racist, right. Try again.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
Thanks, Ambient me.
Yeah,
nice treat I got.
People go like sleepwalking, and they raid the refrigerator in the middle of the night on Ambient, but nobody puts out horror.
Yeah, I don't sleepwalk or anything. Yeah. You don't do anything that is not a kind of thing. Again, he ordered the PS4 because he wants a PS4. I mean, it was still something he likes. It's not like if I ordered a PS4. She, a woman. Wow, playing video games.
I know.
Wow, it happens.
Yeah, so, I'm going to mispronounce his name. James Poniewozik?
Poniewozik.
Poniewozik, the New York Times TV critic, who's great. And he wrote a really great piece, Roseanne Barr Crosses a Line, ABC Draws One, which is, yes, you can make an argument that ABC had this dialed up and ready, but I'm dubious. It was going to make, the estimates were at a minimum season 2, $60 million for ABC. And maybe they had a plan ready. If they're smart, they had a plan ready. Birtherism, nobody cares about. They should. Everybody should be outraged by it. But the president of the United States is a birther. He's the leading birther.
Oh, yeah, no.
The leading famous birther.
She talked about Palestinians for years, and nobody cares.
Right. Those are two things that you're allowed to go after on Ambien in the United States. But you can't call a black person an ape. It's good to know that somewhere along the line we have some standards.
Let me
finish his point was that, hey man, look, you can say what you want and ABC would have had some backlash and there would have been a boycott, but in the end, look man, as Christy said, they did the right thing.
The thing that kills me about all of this and the second round of coverage we saw yesterday was the backlash of like, what, you can't make a joke?
Right.
Like
it's everybody, a free speech thing.
Like, right, and there's a lot of people like, okay, wait a minute, if you're acting in the long, tragic, effed up history of race relations in this country, apes and monkeys, those words were used in a very derogatory way. And if you think that it's okay to go there, maybe think again. Maybe.
And as many people pointed out, you know, if you think that Roseanne getting to say horribly racist stuff is a free speech issue and football players taking a knee during the anthem is not, you're a racist.
And then there is, of course, another argument being made a lot that this is Trump's America now. People feel free to voice the things that maybe they just thought in their heads. And somebody reporters asked Sarah Huckabee Sanders on Air Force One yesterday, what does the president think about this? He had been a big supporter of Roseanne. He called her to congratulate her on her great ratings because ratings are very important to him. And she's like, Sanders is like, he's way too busy. He has too many things to do. He has way too many things to do. Documents and other things. Today he tweeted, Bob Iger of ABC called Valerie Jarrett to let her know that, quote, ABC does not tolerate comments like those made by Roseanne Barr. Gee, he never called President Donald J. Trump to apologize for the horrible, in all caps, statements made and said about me on ABC. Maybe I just didn't get the call?
What a little victim.
Dotard.
A victimizing snowflake. I mean, he loves being the victim.
It's about him.
Right. I mean, it's about what the whole thing about Christianity under assault in this country is. Now, we need a piece of that victimization so that we can feel afflicted. He needs to feel afflicted because that, to him, is when he's at his best and most comfortable. Other tweets said that what about Bill Maher, who many people, I suspect, on this panel have some issues with, but for Bill Maher, comparing Trump to an orange orangutan. And again, to Matt's point, if you can't see the difference between those two things, then you probably need to evaluate your standing.
Yes.